Everybody, sing with us. Yeah, throw your hands up in the air. Welcome back, kids. So, we're continuing our series on
City of Angels.
And this is
Bagel.
And I am
Andrea.
And we're so happy to have you here.
I am so excited. Oh, I've been waiting all week for this.
Same here.
All right.
Okay. So.
So, in today's story, we're going to be learning about how
another angel
appears before somebody
else
named Mary. And the angel tells Mary some wonderful news.
Big news.
This is actually a really important story.
Yeah,
so make sure to stay tuned.
For sure. We're going to find out how she felt, and then we're going to talk about it.
Absolutely.
So, Bagel, you want to pray us in?
I will pray us in.
All right.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for another beautiful, wonderful day, God. Thank you, Lord, for giving us this day. And thank you, Lord, for the lesson and stories that you have for us. Please speak to us, God. We know that you are always listening to our prayers, and we thank you, Lord, for loving us like nobody else. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
All right, now make sure to stay tuned because we're going to have another competition. And this time, we're going to see if I can beat Andrea.
All right, guys, we'll see you soon.
See you soon.
Oh, thank goodness you chicken nuggets are here. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome.
Oh man, oh man, I'm so happy to see y'all. I tell you what, I don't think I've ever been more afraid in my life. For those of you who don't remember from last time, I'm in the city of Los Angeles in California. Now, when I first got here, I really loved it. City lights, good food, and the constant sound of cars honking. It's wonderful, but today I feel a little bit different about it because I was walking down the street minding my own business and a man dressed as Spider-Man jumped on top of me and put me in a headlock. Now remember, this wasn't the Spider-Man. This was just some guy in a costume. And he kept on shaking me around like a rag doll, saying, "Take that, goblin." I don't even know what he's talking about. When I finally shook him off, I went to go grab some food, and well, it wasn't good. I walked up to this restaurant, and they were out of chicken nuggets. Then I asked for a corn dog, but then they just handed me a bowl of corn shaped like a hot dog, like a little corn dog. And if that wasn't enough, next I came face to face with my fear. No, like literally, I ran into a wall with my face, and on the wall they spray painted fear on it. Apparently that's a big thing here, like spray painting things. They call it graffiti. It's everywhere, on the buildings, the light poles, the bathrooms, even like on trains like I seen in the movies. But it makes me wonder, why did someone spray paint the word fear? And why did it scare me? Like for instance, if I see the word boo, I get scared. Ah!
Whoa, what happened?
Oh. Hey Jada, hi. Sorry, I was just a little startled is all. Well, a lot, but most recently I was telling the kids how I ran into a wall. Had the word fear spray painted across it. And I don't know, it just got me scared. Being in a new city, not knowing what it all means. Does that make sense?
For sure, and don't worry. Fear is a completely normal feeling. Everyone I have ever met has felt scared or fearful in at least one point in her life.
Really?
Of course. I mean, if the mother Jesus herself can be scared, I think we're all allowed our moments of fearfulness.
Wait, what are you talking about? Mary was afraid in the Bible?
She sure was. I was just reading about it this morning in Luke chapter 1.
What happened?
Well, you remember the angel that visited Zechariah last week?
For sure. Gabriel, right?
Yep, you got it. Well, Gabriel was sent to visit Mary one night and shared a message with her.
Oh, is this the Jesus message?
You'll have to wait and see.
Well, I know it is.
Now, Mary was going to be married to a man named Joseph, but she wasn't ready for a baby yet. Then the angel Gabriel appeared and said, Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you.
Yeah, that's good news.
Yes, but Mary didn't take it so well at first. Mary was afraid.
Really? Wow. I mean, I guess seeing an angel would be kind of scary at first.
Oh, for sure. But the angel told her to not be afraid. She was told that God was very pleased with her. And because of that, she was going to have a baby and she was going to name him
Jesus. Her baby's name will be Jesus.
Yeah. Exactly. But Mary still was a bit confused because she wasn't ready for a baby and didn't know it would be possible. But Gabriel explained that God was going to perform a miracle through Mary, and there was nothing to be afraid of.
Nothing to be afraid of? Yeah, except like her husband's reaction, her reputation in her community, and having to carry a human baby inside of her for 9 months. Not to mention the weight of being the mother of the Son of God.
True, there was a lot changing in Mary's life, but Gabriel made it very clear that this was God's plan and Mary understood that.
And that's it. So even though the rest of her life had just changed, and even now she'll be facing more troubles in her life, she's not scared?
Oh, I'm sure she was at first, because yes, Mary's life is no longer the same and she'll have to go through some difficult stuff, but here's good news.
Which is?
Jesus is the good news. You see, no matter how much stress, difficult times or scary situations life may throw our way, it all becomes a lot easier to deal with when Jesus is involved.
How's that work? Mary hadn't even met Jesus yet.
True, but she got from the angel's message that God's Son will be the Savior that the world had been waiting for, and we know this now. I mean, Jesus has conquered death. He showed us that nothing in this world can defeat him. And if we choose to follow Jesus, then that means there's nothing to be afraid of too. God will call us to do some big things in this life, but having Jesus on our side makes it so we don't have to be afraid.
Okay, so Mary was no longer afraid because she knew who Jesus and what he's gonna be. And I already know who Jesus is. Wow, you're totally right. I'm not afraid anymore, and I don't care who knows. You hear that, Los Angeles? My name is Coral, and I'm not afraid anymore. Ah! Is that a piece of paper? Who are you, sir?
Well, hey there, kids. Wasn't it cool to hear about Mary's bravery when she found out she was gonna have Jesus? I loved it. That's why today's big idea is such a great reminder. Jesus calms our fears. So let's say it out loud on the count of three, okay? 1, 2, 3. Jesus calms our fears. Great job, everyone. That's it for this week, but we will see you next time on Grow TV. Bye.
Thank you for watching and tune in next week for a new episode of Grow TV.
Every week, we have an opportunity to start a relationship with God. You may be wondering, why do we make such a big deal about this? The problem is, we are born with sin in our hearts, and every day we commit some sin against God. And sin doesn't allow us to have a relationship with God, who is perfect. But God loved us so much that he sent his son Jesus to die on the cross and take the punishment for our sins, punishment that we deserved. Then, 3 days later, God performed a miracle and brought Jesus back to life, defeating sin and death and making it possible for us to have a relationship with God. So, if you're ready to say yes to Jesus and start a friendship with him, all you have to do is tell God that you believe in him. Tell God that you're sorry and ask him to forgive you. I'll lead you in a prayer. All you have to do is bow your head, repeat after me, and really mean it with your whole heart. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner and I have done many wrong things. Please forgive me for all my sins. Jesus, I believe that you died on the cross for all my sins, that God raised you from the dead, and that you are alive today. So I put my trust in you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
That's wonderful. If you just prayed that prayer with me, you have made the best and most important decision of your life. You are now a member of God's family. We are so proud of you and excited for you. Now, there are two things that you need to do. First is tell your parent or another trusted adult that you've prayed and to start your relationship with Jesus. Two, we want to celebrate you, so let us know that you prayed by texting the word KID to 240-269-2100. Welcome to God's family.
Welcome back. That was such a great story.
Okay, so we learned that.